In this video, I'm going to show you how to crochet this cute amigurumi awl. This awl is really easy to make. It is a small and fast to make project. You can make it with any yarn that you like. The small ones are made with sport weight cotton yarn and a 2.5mm crochet hook. It's a perfect size for a keychain. The big one is made with chenille yarn and a 5.0mm crochet hook. I'm going to use port weight cotton yarn in the video because then it's easier to see the stitches that I'm making. If you enjoy making amigurumi, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel. I will be making many more YouTube videos in the future. There's also a written pattern, free written pattern of this awl. You can find it on my website. The link is in the description of this video. If you like making amigurumi, I have many more patterns available. All of these that you see in the video right now are all free YouTube videos and also free written patterns on my website. And you can make them with any yarn that you like. Bigger yarn gives a bigger amigurumi. I'm going to use these small balls of cotton yarn from one colored ball I can make from Twencam. I can make two awls, so one awl is 5g of sport weight cotton yarn. This is a 2.5mm crochet hook that I'm going to use. You need some pins, an embroidery needle. This one has a blunt point and some stuffing to put into your awl amigurumi, scissors to cut your yarn, safety eyes. These are 7mm, so very small. For the big awl I used safety eyes of 13mm. And now we're going to start making one eye. I'm going to start making a magic circle. Wrap the yarn around your finger twice. I'm going to go into those two loops, grab the yarn and pull it to both loops. I have one loop on my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it to the loop on my crochet hook. Well, now I've made the magic circle. If you find the magic circle difficult, please check out my other video about the magic circle and how to make the magic circle in two different ways. The video link is in the top of the corner of this video right now. And now I'll show you how to single crochet 8 times into the magic circle. To the magic circle with your crochet hook, grab the yarn, pull it through. Now you have two loops on your crochet hook. Grab the yarn again and pull it through both loops. So this was the first single crochet, now I'm going to make the second single crochet. Now I'm going to make the third single crochet. And then the fourth single crochet. And the fifth single crochet. Now the sixth. 7, then the 8th single crochet, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 single crochet. Now close the magic circle by pulling a small piece of yarn. One loop will become smaller, don't close it completely yet. Pull on the bottom side of that circle to close the other one completely. And then pull on the small piece of yarn to close the magic circle. I usually end with a slip stitch, but I will show you a bit nicer way to make to end the this round. I'm going to have cut the yarn and pull it through. Now I'm going to sew into the second stitch of the last round. To sew the yarn into the second stitch, and then I'm going to sew into the last stitch that I made. And this way you get a really nice shape for your eyes, eye whites. And now I'm going to start on the ear of the owl. I'm going to first start with a magic circle. Wrap the yarn around your finger twice. Go into those toe rounds. Grab the yarn, pull it through. Now have one loop on your crochet hook. Grab the yarn again and pull it through the loop on your crochet hook. Now I've made the magic circle and this time we're going to single crochet 4 times into the magic circle. This is the first single crochet and the second single crochet, the third single crochet, one more, and now we've made 4 single crochets. Now I can close the magic circle by pulling the small piece of yarn. One loop will become smaller. Then I'm going to pull on that bottom of that loop to close the other one completely, pull the small piece of yarn again, and I've closed the magic circle. Now we're going to make another round 2. In the next round, I'm going to single crochet in the first stitch and make an increase in every second stitch. First, I'm going to place some marker yarn so that I can see where my round starts. And then I'm going to go into the first stitch and I'm going to single crochet 1 time into the first stitch. Now I'm going to go into the second stitch and then I'm going to single crochet 2 times in the same stitch. That's called an increase. In the next stitch, I'm going to single crochet 1 time. And in the last stitch, the second stitch, I'm going to increase again 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Now I'm done with the second round. We're going to make the third round. First, I'm going to place the marker yarn. And then I'm going to single crochet 1 time in every stitch of the round. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. And also on the next. So in every stitch of the round, 1 single crochet. This is also the last round of the first ear. Now this is the last single crochet of the third round. Now I'm going to fasten off with the slip stitch. So I'm going to go into the next stitch. I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it through the stitch, but also immediately to the loop on my crochet hook. This is how you make a slip stitch. Now I can cut the yarn and pull it through. Now we're going to make the other ear. I'm going to start with a magic circle. And in the magic circle, we're going to make 4 single crochets. This is the first single crochet, now the second, third, and one more, 4 single crochets. And now we're going to close the magic circle, pull the small piece of yarn, then pull on the bottom of the loop, and pull the small piece of yarn again to close the magic circle. Now in the first round, this is going to be the same as the first ear. First place a piece of marker yarn. Use another color than the other ear. So you can see the difference between the left and the right ear. And now we're going to do 1 single crochet in every first stitch. And in every second stitch we're going to single crochet 2 times. An increase. And do this again in the first stitch, 1 single crochet. And in the second stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Now move the marker yarn and we're going to start with the third round. This is a really easy round. Just one single crochet in every stitch of the round. Just one more single crochet, and I'm not going to fasten off. Now, first we're going to go into the next round, and we're going to single crochet one time in the first three stitches. So first place your marker yarn, and then single crochet in the first three stitches. And then we're going to make a chain with four chain stitches. So grab the yarn and pull it to the loop in your crochet hook. This is the first chain stitch, then the second, the third, one more, four chain stitches. Now I'm going to get my other ear and I'm going to go continue into the first stitch of the last round that we made. This is the stitch where also the slip stitch is in. So I'm going to single crochet one time in each stitch of the round. So that means you're going to make six single crochets in total. When you made the single crochet in the last stitch of the round, then we're going to crochet into the chain again. I will show you exactly where you need to start. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the fourth chain stitch, and that is exactly where you need to start. You're going to make one single crochet in every chain stitch. You will notice there's maybe a little gap between the last single crochet and the single crochet that you're going to make now. But this will be alright when we continue to crochet the body. Now I'm going to go into the second chain stitch. And make another single crochet, and also in the third chain stitch, one single crochet. Also in the last one, one single crochet. And then I'm going to crochet into the ear again. This is the third stitch. We're going to continue to crochet in the fourth stitch. Make one single crochet. And also in the fifth and the sixth stitch, so in total you will be making three single crochets, one single crochet in the fourth, fifth, and sixth stitch of the second ear. Until you are at the end of the second ear. Now we're going to single crochet one time in every stitch. So in the end we have made 20 single crochets. The first part is easy. Still crocheting in the ear. This is the third single crochet. And now we're going to single crochet in a chain. I will show you exactly how to do this, because this is a bit more difficult to see where to start. One, two, three, four. This is the fourth. So this is where you have to start making your next single crochet. Let me use a needle to show you in close-up where to start. So, this is the stitch where we're going to start. This is the second, third, and this is the fourth. the next ones are going to be really much easier, because then you just have to stitch single crochet into single crochets. So I've been using a different kind of color marker yarn, so now I know exactly where I wound 5 starts, because if I used the same color, then I would probably got confused where the beginning of my round is. Now I'm going to crochet in the ear again. This is the first stitch where we have to crochet in the ear. Continue to make 1 single crochet in the next stitches until the end of the round. So 1 single crochet in every stitch. This is quite easy, so I'm going to speed up the video a bit. Now I'm going to move the marker yarn and start on round 6. First I'm going to make an increase in the first stitch. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And when I'm done with the first stitch, I'm going to make 1 single crochet in the next 9 stitches. And I'm going to do that twice. So in every first single crochet, an increase. 2 single crochets in the same stitch, and then in the next 9 stitches, 1 single crochet. If you're not sure if you made 9 stitches, you can always count the stitches on the top side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So now I can make another increase. So in the first stitch 1, an increase, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And in the next 9 stitches, only 1 single crochet. In the next round, we're going to make 1 increase in the first stitch, and in the next 10 stitches, 1 single crochet, and we're going to repeat this 2 times in total. So now I'm going to, in the next 10 stitches, 1 single crochet. Now repeat it again. In the first stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch, the increase. And in the next 10 stitches, 1 single crochet in every stitch. In round 8, we're going to single crochet in the first 3 stitches, and we're going to make an increase in every 4th stitch. So in this first stitch 1 single crochet, in the second 1 single crochet, in the third 1 single crochet, and in the fourth an increase. 2 single crochets in the same stitch, and I'm going to repeat this 5 more times. So 6 times in total, 1 single crochet in the first 3 stitches. and then an increase in every fourth stitch. Now this is the last increase of round 8, and then we can start on round 9. Round 9, 10, 11 and 12 are really easy. Just one single crochet of every stitch of the round. So for 4 rounds are really easy, just one single crochet in every stitch. Now this last single crochet of round 12. Now I'm going to move the marker yarn. And before I continue to crochet the next round, I'm going to place the safety eyes and the eye whites in the eye whites. First, I'm going to place the safety eyes in the eye whites. If this is a bit difficult, use a little tool to make the hole a bit bigger. And then you can put your safety eye to the magic circle. And then we can place the safety eyes on the body. I'm going to place the safety eyes between round 8 and 9 with 4 stitches between the eyes. So this is round 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So between row 8 and 9, on the front of the body, we're going to place the safety eyes, and there are going to be 4 stitches between both eyes. I'm going to place the first eye here, and the second eye here. There are 4 stitches between both eyes. This is the first eye. Just making the holes a bit bigger, so it's easier to place the safety eyes. Once you have attached them both in the body, then look on the front to see if they are if it looks correctly. If they do, if they don't, have to be placed a little bit more to the right or left, then you can place the washers on the safety eyes in the inside of the body. Washers can be a little bit difficult to attach, so they are quite hard sometimes. This one is easy, but if they are a bit difficult, then use a cap of a marker to place them on, because that will make it a bit easier to do. But these safety eyes are very easy to attach. It probably means they're not that safe, But if it's going very hard, it's better. And then use the cap of a marker or something else to attach the safety, the washes on the safety eyes. Now we need to sew on the eye whites on the body. I'll show you exactly how I do that. I'm just twisting it a bit, the eyes, until I think they look correctly. And then I will start sewing on the eye whites. Now again, now I've sewed on the eyes, and I'm going to sew in the white yarn, so it's inside the body, and then I'm going to sew on the other eye. Now I'm going to sew the yarns with inside of the body, and then I'm going to make a little knot in the two pieces of white yarn. If you want, you can attach just a little loop of yarn on the top of your awl to attach a keychain. Of course, you can also directly attach the keychain to the awl, which is probably a bit safer. If you want to use a piece of yarn, make sure that you sew in the yarn on the inside of the body and also make a very strong knot, because you don't want to be able to pull out the yarn and lose your awl. So I think it's probably better just to attach the keychain to the awl directly. But this is optional, of course. Now we're going to continue to crochet our body. We're going to start with round 13. In round 13, we're going to single crochet in the first 3 stitches, and then we're going to make a decrease. I will show you how to do this. This is the second stitch, this is the third stitch, and now we're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together. To do this, go into the front loops, only the front loops of your next 2 stitches. And then grab the yarn and pull it through both front loops. Now, grab the yarn again and pull it through the 2 loops on your crochet hook. Now, that's just how you make an invisible decrease. Let me show you one more time how to do this, and then I will show you also how to make a normal decrease, because an invisible decrease can be a bit hard when you're working with plush yarn. So this is the invisible decrease, And then let me show you the... when you make a normal decrease, you go into the next stitch, and not only the front loop, the whole stitch, and you grab the yarn and pull it through. You go to the second stitch, grab the yarn and pull it through. And now you have three loops in your crochet hook, and you pull the yarn through those three loops. Now that's how you make a normal decrease. And for plus yarn, this is much easier. And you won't see the decrease because, well, it's very fluffy yarn. Now I'm going to continue with the awl. Dus in the first three stitches, one single crochet, and in every fourth and fifth stitch, you're going to crochet together. Make a decrease. Before I continue with the next round, I'm going to sew on the beak because I forgot about it. So I'm going to sew the beak between the eyes over the 10th round. I'm going to sew several times over the same spot to over round 9 to create a create a beak. Now you just have to make a little knot on the inside of the body, and then we can continue to crochet round 14 of the body. In the next round, we're going to single crochet in the first two stitches, and we're going to decrease the third and the fourth stitch. So in these two stitches, we're going to crochet together, make a decrease, and then in the next two stitches, one single crochet, and you have to repeat this until the end of the round. So in the first two stitches, one single crochet, and then crochet the next two stitches together. This is the last decrease of round 14, and then we're going to start on round 15. In round 15, we're going to do one single crochet in every first stitch, and we're going to crochet the second and third stitch together. We're going to repeat this for the whole round. One single crochet in the first stitch, and every next two stitches, you're going to crochet together. This last decrease, and then we're going to put some stuffing in the body before we make the next round. Of course, the ears are very tiny, so I'm going to use chopsticks to put the stuffing in the ear. In the next round, we're going to decrease 6 times. That means that we're going to crochet every first and second stitch together. Then cut the yarn and pull it through. Now you can remove the marker yarn because we do not need it anymore. I'm going to put a bit more stuffing in the body. I'm going to use a chopstick to do this because the hole is very tiny now. I'm going to sew the remaining yarn in every front loop of the last round that we made. And once you have done that, you can pull on the yarn to close the last round. And then you have to sew in the remaining yarn several times in the body to hide the remaining yarn. Now the body is done and I'm going to show you how to make the wings of the owl. We're going to start with a magic circle, wrap the yarn around your finger twice, go into those two loops, grab the yarn and pull it through the loops. Grab the yarn and pull it through the loop on your crochet hook. We're going to single crochet 6 times into this magic circle. This is the first single crochet, and the second single crochet, the third single crochet, the fourth, the fifth, and one more, 6 single crochets. Now I'm going to close the magic circle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I'm going to pull that small piece of yarn to make one loop smaller. I'm going to pull on the bottom side of that loop to make the other, to close the other loop completely, and then I'm going to pull the small piece of yarn again to close the magic circle completely. Now we're going to start on round 2. In round 2, I'll first put in a piece of marker yarn. And then we're going to do 2 increases. So in the first stitch, we're going to increase 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Then in the second stitch, 2 single crochets. In the next stitch, we're going to do half double crochet and a double crochet and a half double crochet in the same stitch. Go in under your yarn with your crochet hook and then go into the stitch. And then grab the yarn and pull it to the stitch. Now you have 3 loops in crochet hook. Now grab the yarn and pull it to all 3 loops. This is a half double crochet. Now I'm going to go under the yarn again with my crochet hook. Then I'm going to go into the same stitch and I'm going to grab the yarn and I'm going to pull it to the stitch. Now I have 3 loops on my loops on my crochet hook, and I'm going to grab the yarn but only pull it to the first 2 loops on my crochet hook. Now I have 2 loops on my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it to both loops. Now I have to make a half double crochet in the same stitch. Go under the yarn and then go into your same stitch. Grab the yarn and pull it to that stitch. I have 3 loops on your crochet hook. Now I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it to the 3 loops. This is a half double crochet. Now in the next stitch we're going to do an increase. So 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And also next stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And one more time. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Now we're going to put the yarn and pull it through. And now I'm going to sew in the remaining yarn. And first I will remove the yarn that's sticking out of the magic circle. And I'm going to sew in the yarn into the second stitch of the last round. So this is the second stitch. And then I'm going to go into the stitch we just made. And now we've made one wing and you have to make one more. And then we're going to sew them on the body. We're going to sew them below the ninth round of the body. And there are going to be 10 stitches between both wings. I will show you exactly where and how to sew on the wings. You can see that there are about 2 stitches between the eyes and the wings. I have to hide the remaining yarn. I'm going to hide the remaining yarn under the wing. Going to sew it in several times. Going to cut off this yarn and then I will show you how to sew on the other wing. The wing on the other side is also placed below the ninth round. And I will show you exactly how to sew this wing on the body. Now, I'm going to sew in the wing and I'm going to use the remaining yarn to sew the stripes on the body. As the remaining yarn is the same color as the stripes. If you don't have enough yarn, you can start hiding your new yarn under your ring and then start making the stripes. The stripes are going to be sewed between round 11 and 12. I'm also going to sew a few stripes between the 12th and the 13th round. Those are going to make four stripes and then three below that on the between the 11th and the 12th round. Three stripes. Now I can hide the remaining yarn in the wing and under the wing. And now your awl is done. Thank you very much for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed making this cute awl. If you did, please like my video and subscribe to my channel. I will be making many more patterns and videos. If you enjoy making amigurumi, please check out the other videos on my YouTube channel. All the videos are also available as written patterns on my website, free written patterns. For example, this cute red panda and this adorable little pig. There are many patterns available for many amigurumi on my website and my YouTube channel. And they're all perfect for beginners that want to learn how to crochet. For example, this very cute cat. And you can make them all from cotton yarn. Or if you want, you can use other yarn, like Chanel Plus yarn that I use for this bigger cat. I also made a book with amigurumi patterns. The link to this book is on my website. I also have an Etsy shop with lots of written patterns. For example, this koala and this very cute donkey. These are all quite big patterns. They're easy to make, but they just take a bit more time than the small ones. But if you're up to something more challenging, I would give it a try, because it's not difficult to do. Thank you for watching!